There was more curiosity than hostility between the Aborigines and the new tribe from Britain, as can be seen in this painting by Lieutenant Bradley, which captures them dancing together. But 18 months in, quite suddenly, the Aborigines began to die. Not by the musket, but by something even more devastating. Smallpox.
You said that smallpox took Arabano. Was that something that was known on the Australian continent before the Europeans arrived?
Probably the greatest mystery of early Australian history is where this smallpox came from. And there's a number of alternative theories. One is that perhaps Indonesians brought it into northern Australia and it had been working its way down and just happened to break out when the first fleet arrived. Another one was that it was aboard the French fleets, because there was a French expedition that met the first fleet in Botany Bay at the time it arrived. But none of them make sense much, because the smallpox breaks out after 18 months. You know, so where was it all of that time? But once it broke out, it spread like wildfire.
The beaches were strewn with the dead and dying, and no one had an answer for how it got into the population. The First Fleet surgeon, John White, brought with him a piece of material imbued with a smallpox sample. It was locked away for the purposes of inoculation. Could it have been tampered with?
Do you reckon this was done deliberately?
Oh, absolutely not. It's clear from the reaction of everyone, from Governor Philip Down and the surgeon and others. They came around to caves like this all around the harbour, finding dead and dying Aboriginal people in them, and did their very best to help them. And in fact, they brought Aboriginal children who were suffering from smallpox back to the settlement and fed them and looked after them. And so I don't think it was deliberate at all. It was a great tragedy. Australian